Hello everyone, let's pray for each other to have day filled with happiness, healthy, safety, abundance, peace and love. With this thought, a very fresh good morning to all. But before that, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel so that you will get the notification for upcoming one. Before moving further in the chapter, let's revise or recapitulate some of the topics which we have done previously. Yesterday we have discussed different categories of matter. Here we are having the flow chart which shows the different categories of matter. Basically, matter is of two types, pure substances and impure substances. Pure substances are further of two types, elements and compounds. Let us take pure substance, let us recapitulate it. Pure substances are those substances which are having only one kind of particle. These particles can be an atom or a molecule, and these pure substances cannot be separated by any physical method. These pure substances are of three types. The next category we are having impure substances, which are also known as mixtures. Mixtures are those substances which are made up of two or more substances, but these substances which are present in mixture are not chemically combined. We will discuss it further. Let us discuss the first category of pure substances, that is element. Yesterday also we have done this. It's a pure substance that cannot be broken into different substances by any physical or chemical matter. It is of three types. You can see the example of different elements like neon, hydrogen, oxygen. Only one kind of particle is present and they cannot be further divided. Basically, elements are of three types, metals, non-metals and metalloids. Yesterday we have done their properties and their uses in day-to-day life. We have done so many examples of these three categories. Now, suppose you are mixing 100 gram of pearls with 100 gram of rice. What will you get? Yes, a mixture of these two. Is it necessary that every time you have to take same amount of pearls or rice to cook your food? No, it's not necessary. Similarly, let us take one more example. As you know that in air, water molecules are present in different amount. Is it necessary that every time same amount of water molecules should be present? Not necessary. So we can say that whenever we mix two or more substances in any amount or ratio, we get a mixture. On the other hand, let us take one example, water. In water, you can easily see from the slide here, two atoms of hydrogen are combined with one atom of oxygen. What does it mean? Are they chemically combined or are they present in the fixed ratio? To get the answer of this question, let us start with our next topic, compounds. Mainly, compounds are those substances which are made up of two or more elements, and these elements are chemically combined with each other. And the particles or elements present in a compound, they are present in the fixed ratio by their mass. What is the meaning of this line, fixed ratio by mass? It means the elements which are present in the compounds are always combined in the fixed amount by their mass. You can take the example of water. Here you can see in water, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen is present. Here, these atoms are chemically combined and even they are present in the fixed ratio by their mass. How? In water, hydrogen is present in 1 gram and oxygen is present in 8 gram. It means the ratio of their combination should be 1:8. It's fixed. Suppose you are taking 3 grams of hydrogen. So you have to take 24 grams of oxygen so that their combination ratio should be 1:8 finally. Now, the next example, we are having carbon dioxide, in which two atoms of oxygen combined with one atom of carbon. Here, again, their ratio is fixed, that is 3:8. If 3 grams of carbon combines with 8 gram of oxygen, then they produces carbon dioxide, that is CO2. The next example, we are having ammonia, that is NH3. Here one atom of nitrogen and 3 atoms of hydrogen are combined chemically, in which nitrogen is present as 14 grams and hydrogen is present as 3 grams by their mass. We can conclude that a composition of compound is always fixed. That means the constituents are present in a fixed proportion by their mass whenever compound is formed. Again, in the next slide, you are having the example of the combination of different atoms to make or to form different compounds like water, ammonia, hydrogen peroxide and carbon dioxide. They are some common compounds. Whenever compound is formed, their constituent particles are always combined in the fixed amount by their mass. It cannot be changed. It is fixed. Let us understand compounds with the help of this upcoming video.
Bringing elements together since the beginning of time. Chemical compounds. When two or more elements combine, we've got a chemical compound. Let's take a look at the element O, or oxygen, found on the periodic table of elements. Oxygen is just one type of atom. Here, we represent this atom with a blue circle. Another element found on the periodic table of elements is hydrogen. Hydrogen is just one type of atom that we can represent with a red circle. Now, let's take two hydrogen atoms. Get up. We will combine these two hydrogen atoms with one oxygen atom. This is a chemical compound known as H2O. Get up. H2O is better known to us as water. Water contains two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom that have been chemically combined. Carbon is another element found on the periodic table of elements. Carbon is just one type of atom that we represent here with a yellow circle. Oxygen, once again, is found on the periodic table of elements and is just one type of atom that we will represent with a blue circle. Let's take two oxygen atoms and one carbon atom. When these three atoms combine, they form a chemical compound known as CO2. CO2 contains one carbon, two oxygen atoms. This compound is better known as carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, one carbon atom and two oxygen atoms chemically combined. Chemical compounds, when two or more elements combine.
Again and again, one question arises in our minds. The molecules are formed when two or more atoms of elements combine together. And even in compounds, there is a combination of two or more atoms of elements. Is there any difference or they are same? Let us understand it with upcoming video.
So molecules versus compounds. Well, when we look at molecules and compounds, molecules are kind of the overarching theme here. So we have our molecules and then we have our compounds. So compounds are just a type of molecule. So every compound is going to be a molecule. So let's think about that. We have molecules, which are two or more elements. So things like O2, we have two oxygens chemically bonded. Or H2O, we have two hydrogens and an oxygen chemically bonded. Or CaCl2. Those are molecules because there's two or more elements. For compounds, again, we have two or more elements, but this time it's two or more different elements. So we'll have something like CaCl2, we have calcium and chlorines, those are different elements. So that makes it a compound, It's also a molecule. And then HCl, we have a hydrogen and a chlorine, two different elements that makes it a compound, and again, it's also a molecule. Let's try one. So pause if you need to think about it. So for CH4, we have carbon and four hydrogens. So we have more than two elements. That makes it a molecule, but they're also different, so it's a compound as well. Something like P4, we have four phosphorus atoms chemically bonded, so two or more elements gives you a molecule. But in this case, they're all the same, so we don't have different elements. Therefore, it can't be a compound. P4 is just a molecule. One last one here. Calcium sulfate, we have calcium, sulfur, and four oxygen. So we have more than two elements chemically bonded. That's a molecule. And then they're different. We have the calcium, sulfur, and oxygen. So it's also a compound. This is Dr. B with the Molecules versus Compounds, and thanks for watching.
I hope you have understood the previous concept. But one more time, one more question in our mind. Compound is formed when two or more elements are combined together. Then why it is considered as pure? As we know that compounds are made up of only one kind of molecules. So there is no physical method that can separate these compounds into their constituent atoms. Even they have fixed chemical composition which cannot be changed. The next we are having the difference between compound and element. As we know that these compound and elements are the two types of pure substances. So how they are different from each other? A compound contains atoms of different elements which are chemically combined with each other in the fixed ratio. But element is the pure substance which contains only one type of atom. A compound can be represented by using a formula. It is having a specific formula to represent. But an element is represented by its symbol only. There is no physical or chemical method which can separate an element further. But by chemical method, compound can be separated into its constituent atoms. But not by physical methods. Let us understand it better.
created using Paltoon.
I hope you have understood all previous topics which we have done today. So here we are having assignment. Please go through these questions, and if any problem or any doubt, please write down in comment box. Thank you and have a nice day. And please remember, keep doing your revision on daily basis.